Hey everybody, my name is Jay Schultz. I'm a technical account manager with Fortify on Demand. And today we're gonna be talking about cleanse rules, a new feature which came out in our 19.5 release, which we're all very excited about here at Fortify on Demand. What cleanse rules does is it's another tool that your developers and security leads can use in an effort to reduce noise. Cleanse rules works with one of our scan tools, the Dataflow analyzer, and it works to remove taint flags. And that's all something that we'll talk about in a second. First, let's talk about what the Dataflow analyzer is. Now, Fortify on Demand uses a number of different tools in detecting vulnerabilities. And one of those tools is called the Dataflow analyzer. Now the Dataflow analyzer, what it'll do is, it determines where inputs are coming in. It has to assume that any source of data is malicious data or secure data or sensitive data, and it's going to add a taint flag to it. So anytime any input is detected in the code, it's going to raise a taint flag and it's going to place it on that piece of data, that variable. And then what it does is, it actually moves through the code and follows that as it moves through different classes, functions, and packages, and then it detects if that data is being used at the sink. The sink is the point where the data is consumed, and for instance, if one of the vulnerabilities you were looking at was the cross-site scripting reflected in the DOM, one of the things that the Dataflow analyzer would do would look for the sink where that tainted data is reflected back and written to the DOM. So first off, you'd have a function that reads or takes an input, and we call that the source. So the source is our input here. This is where data is coming in, whether it's coming in from anywhere outside the program, anywhere outside the application, whether it's a user input, whether it's from an external source like an API, any source of data, it's going to be picked up by the data source analyzer, and the data source analyzer is going to put what we call it a taint flag on it. Now the data source analyzer, let's put a little taint flag. Here's a little taint flag. Because it taint good. Our taint flag is set on this variable. Now what the Dataflow analyzer can't do is it can't determine, it's not there to make a subjective call on whether this data is actually tainted. It can't know if, it can't determine if a piece of data is actually safe. It can't determine if a piece of data came from a trusted source. All it can tell is that it came from outside the application. And so anytime a data source is coming from outside the application, this taint flag is going to be raised. And then of course, once we pull our source into our application, the Dataflow analyzer is going to follow it as it goes through a function and another function and another function. And then, if you log into the portal and you look at a particular vulnerability and you go to the diagram, you'll actually see the Dataflow analyzer and the work that it's done as it tracks through the different functions, the different conditionals, and the different packages as the data makes its way through the flow of the application. And then eventually, it's going to come out at the other end, and we call that the sink. And the sink is where that data is used, whether it's written to a database, whether it's reflected back in the DOM, it's being consumed. Now, best practice tells us that at some point, we should validate this, right? We don't want malicious code in there. We don't want them to be able to reflect JavaScript onto our DOM. We don't want them to be able to redirect the user. We don't want them to be able to inject SQL code into our database. And so best practice is going to tell us that somewhere here, one of these functions is going to be a cleansing function. And so we would pass our data through this cleansing function before it gets to the sink. That's supposed to be an arrow. But again, because of our data flow analyzer, our data flow analyzer isn't going to be able to actually validate that this cleanse function does what it's supposed to do or that it properly cleanses it. But as a security lead or developer, you can write these cleanse functions specifically for certain data sets and make sure that your data is properly cleansed before it reaches the sink. So here's where cleanse rules come in. And this is, a new feature that we just added into 19.5. And the reason we're excited about it is because the data flow analyzer tracks all this, but we are able to actually send cleanse rules into the data flow analyzer, mark them as proper cleanse functions, and remove the taint flag before it reaches the sink. Therefore, instead of like, say, the audit template, where we set up certain rules and certain logic to suppress vulnerabilities, this is actually pre-scan. The audit template is post-scan. After we get our results back from the scan, we can filter those and suppress the ones that meet the criteria. The cleanse rules are pre-scan, so we tell the scanner, the data flow analyzer, before it runs the scan, which cleanse functions we have that are valid, and which cleanse functions work with which categories. So we can specifically say, cross-site scripting, we have this cleanse function, fix cross-site scripting, whatever we want to call it. That cleanse function removes, validates our data, makes it safe for cross-site scripting, removes that possibility before it reaches the sink. And so we can say with our cleanse rule, we can say if it reaches that function and it's a cross-site scripting vulnerability, ignore it. And so it's not the cleanse rule removes the taint flag from our source. And so the vulnerability is not triggered on the sink, which means we won't see it in the portal at all. We won't see it in our reports. And if it existed at one point and we added the cleanse rule, it will mark it as fixed validated. But the point is that you will not ever see these vulnerabilities if they're properly cleansed with the proper cleanse function. And so let's flip the board here and we'll see a little bit of what I'm talking about. So here we have a source, and this can be, read, or scanf. It's getting a little light there, but here's where our source is. We've written a cleanse rule that says we do this in the portal. It's set up a lot like audit templates. It's going to be under the same category. Where we can determine in our cleanse rule, we can specify that validate data or val data. So we say in the portal, we'll say the cleanse function is val data. And we'll say what package it's in. We'll point out, we're able to zero in on exactly where this val data function exists. And so our cleanse function is called val data. Now we've told the data flow analyzer what our cleanse function is. And so the data flow analyzer, when it sees the source, read, scanf, it puts that taint flag on there, right? If the data flow analyzer sees the data flow through the cleanse function, it removes the taint. All other functions, any other function, any set of functions that it passes through, if it doesn't go through our val data, the taint flag remains. That's a taint flag. And then a vulnerability is listed here. And so then over here, our sync can be, string length, sprint def, whatever. Maybe print. So in the portal, what I do is I set up val data as my cleanse function. The data flow analyzer now recognizes cleanse function as a valid cleanse function that will validate the data and remove the flag. And if the source passes through this, no vulnerability. No vuln. But if it does anything else, vuln. And the cleanse function doesn't have to be the only function in between. There can be a series of functions because the data flow analyzer is going to follow your source all the way through your code. As long as it passes through the cleanse function, and this is important, it has to return the value of the cleanse function. The data has to be one of the arguments that goes into the cleanse function, and the data has to be one of the values that's returned from the cleanse function. So you just need to make sure that your sync and your cleanse function are separate. So with the data flow analyzer, this is another reason why having a complete payload of your application is so important, because this data flow analyzer tracks your source as it moves through your application. So that's why even if you have third-party libraries that you don't want to be scanned, it's important to include those binaries, because we'll be able to track that source through the binary, through the third-party library, and pull it as it comes out the other end of that third-party library and track it through the code. Long story short, you should always include the source code of any application and any file that you want scanned for vulnerabilities, and you should include the binaries for every third-party library or dependency that's included with your application. They don't need to be scanned, but they should be included. So that's cleanse rules, and now maybe you have a little more information about how powerful they are, because they're really an incredible tool in reducing noise. Because what's going to happen is the data flow analyzer by default is going to see all sources as tainted and all syncs as tainted, consuming that tainted data. What the cleanse rule does for you is it enables you and your developers to create cleanse functions, standardize them across all your applications if you want to, and set them in the portal so that when you see a particular source being raised and it passes through a particular cleanse function and it meets the criteria of a particular category, that taint flag is removed. And you'll see a heavy reduction in the amount of noise, and you'll be left with very actionable results. And I know that was very brief, and we covered that pretty quickly. So if you have any questions, feel free to reach out to me or reach out to one of your technical account managers, or raise a ticket in the help desk, and we'd be happy to talk to you about cleanse rules and how they can work for you and your organization.